Hello everybody, so I am back to film a haul video. It has been quite some time since I filmed the haul video, and this haul video is gonna focus on what I brought back from BeautyCon LA 2015. I figured this would be very informative and some good insight about what brands go to BeautyCon, what items are at BeautyCon for purchase, etc., etc. And I honestly will say that everything is not in its original packaging right now because I live in Virginia. I have to try to condense everything together to make it packing friendly. So I usually take off the packaging while in my hotel room and then bring back the item. So keep in mind that I will mention what the packaging looks like or if it was adorable or whatever the heck, or you know, generally what I remember from it. But everything is in these little like packing baggies right now because NYX gave out a huge bag to the talent, aka like the social media, the Instagrammers, the YouTubers, etc., etc. They have a huge goodie bag, and I gave a lot away to one of my subscribers that met me the next day. I basically made a bag of things I already own or I don't need because I have way more than anyone could ever possibly need, and I gave it to the first person I met the next day because I ran into a lot of viewers out there. So if we said hey, we took pictures, thank you guys for coming up to me and for, you know, watching my videos and all the support and all of that. I wish I could give goodie bags to all of you guys, but literally the last day after BeautyCon, I just condensed it all. I had a bunch of stuff and I don't need it all, but I do have a couple things to show you guys still. Let's start with NYX. They were extremely generous as they are every year, every event. And if you're wondering, I will be at BeautyCon New York in October, and I'm also going to IMATS Toronto in September. So those are the two other beauty events. I'm also going to VidCon this month in LA, so hope to see some of you guys there. The thing I was so excited about was that they gave, I think it seems like it's all of the shades to their brand new liquid suede cream lipsticks. I haven't tried them yet, so I figured I would try maybe like one of the colors out right now, like maybe one of these light colors, just because. I have a color on my lips right now. I'm wearing one of the new shades from the L'Oreal La Matte, and this is in 102 She's So Matte, if you're wondering what is on my lips. So these are huge. These are probably one of the biggest NYX lip products ever. These are the Liquid Suede Cream Lipsticks, and I'm gonna try out shade 9, and it's Tea and Cookies. So it has like a flat doe foot applicator. Oh wow, this is not my color for sure. It's really light though, like light in texture, which is nice, application wise. It gives a good amount of control. It's not really like a color that I go for. I don't really lean into pinks, but it's a little bit pinker than the tube makes you think. Sorry about that, guys. Definitely is a really pretty shade though. So this is Tea and Cookies. It clashes with my hair a little bit, but if you guys don't mind, then I'm just gonna keep it on the rest of the video. It doesn't feel sticky or anything at all, so that's awesome. I want to do a video just swatching all of the colors for you guys, so that'll be a separate video. But there are a very large 10 or 11, or maybe all 12 of these, I might have misplaced one. And they range from like purples to nudes. There's like two brown nudes. I kind of want to try the nude right now. And there's some reds and your pinks and like really vibrant purple. So that's pretty awesome. I need to silence my phone. They're not hard to remove, so that's nice at least. We're going to try out one of the nudes just because I just have to know. Sandstorm. Sounds cool. I'm surprised at how opaque Sandstorm is. It's really nice and really smooth. One coat does the job. Usually, like liquid nudes, they're hard to come by, and then at the same time, they're really hard to apply usually because the formula kind of lacks because it's so light, it lacks a lot of pigmentation. So this is really nice. I like it. We're gonna wear this one for the rest of the video. Then they released some new concealers, which I haven't heard of until the event, and it's called the Gotcha Covered Coverage. Nope, it's called Gotcha Covered. Never mind. They gave us all of the shades, and this is a waterproof concealer that's supposed to be full coverage. I haven't tried it yet, but I can't wait to do so, and I'll let you guys know. Maybe I'll do like a love it or leave it on it and swatch all the shades for you. I think that sounds like the best idea for those concealers because there's so many of them. There's like 5 or 6. And then they came out with the lid lacquers, which to me look like the liquid versions of their Jumbo Milk. I keep calling it Milk, but Jumbo Pencils, the cream eyeshadow bases. There's one that says clear transparent. It's supposed to be a lid lacquer that helps deliver a high shine for a glossy edge eye look. So I might be wrong completely. And this one's black. I don't really know how you use these, but these are brand new. So we're gonna figure that out. I think it'd be cooler if it was matte personally, but I guess glossy. Oh, it's like, looks like eyelash glue. It's crazy. I don't know what you'd do with that. I guess if you're going for some sort of metallic look or maybe like a glossy eyeliner look, I would hope that it dries fully. Another new product is the Whipped. I don't even know how to say this, guys, so I'm not even gonna try, but these Whipped products, and these are lip and cheek souffles for your face and lips. I don't know what the consistency is like. I don't really like products like this. I don't use them much. Like, you know, you can use cream blush for your lips and cheeks. It's not really my thing. It's more for those drier skin. I just stick to powders because I'm already oily enough, so I try not to go too far, but sometimes it's nice for your lips because it's really light and leaves like a stain look. They smell like vanilla. That's pretty awesome. This is the color Coralsicle, like creamsicle, but with coral. I don't think this looks coral at all. I think it looks very creamsicle. But it's a very pretty shade. Let's see. Let's dab it out a little bit. It feels really light and velvety, similar to like silicone primer. So it could be very, very pretty on the cheeks. If you can imagine, if you applied this on your lips and blended it out, it would give a really soft, like matte color, but like just a tint of it, which would be nice. Some of the other shades look like this. This is Plush, which is something I would use. It's like a pinky brown mauve. And then this is Berry Tea. That's pretty. And then of course they have a red, and this is Molten Love. When I patted it out on my hand, it dried really, really fast. So I like that because it'd be perfect for cheeks. I don't like it when it stays like too tacky, because that would mess things up. Since I have you guys close up, I figured I'd let you guys look at my lashes. These are from my friend Sophia's lash line that just launched recently. It's from Superficial by Sophia Tao, and I'll link them off down below. I'm wearing the Flawless style, which is definitely my favorite. It's like right in the styles that I usually would wear. Nice and full, nice and fluffy and wispy. I love wispy lashes, and they're very, very comfortable. So if you are interested in checking them out, check them out down below. Chi handed me their new portable to-go straightener, which is crazy. They were testing it on other people there. It's something that you can charge like a cell phone, supposedly, and you can just throw this in your purse or something. My purse isn't that big. It has a low, medium, high setting. Oh, it just turned on. It's really nice and small. If it heats up hot enough, I think it's actually a really cool on-the-go type of tool. Maybe I'll just let this heat and we'll see how it does, even though my hair is already technically straightened. Then I stopped by the Velvet 59 booth, which is a new brand. They contacted me on Instagram and I was happy to stop by their booth. She had a lot of amazing things. These products are all cruelty-free, vegan, and gluten-free, and paraben-free. This is a palette. This is the Exotic Lotus palette. It reminds me a lot of Thailand because of just like the packaging of it. As you can see, these are beautiful, beautiful shades. I haven't swatched them yet, but let's check it out. These are shades I would use, these browns. Beautiful. They're very nice. This is just like one swipe, no primer. She also gave me some of her lipsticks that look like this. Look how extravagant the packaging is. Look how beautiful. It almost looks like something out of a Disney book. Gorgeous. This is, I have no clue what shade it is, to be honest. It says 15E1 at the bottom of it. There's no sticker, so I'm not really sure. But it's a very, very pretty nude color. This reminds me of Shy Girl from MAC. NYX also gave out the Be Gone Lip Color Remover, so that's cool. It's supposed to thoroughly condition your lips while helping wipe away long-lasting lip colors, which I'm assuming go hand in hand with these lip suedes. They also had a box there that had a sample, a very large sample of the Wen Cleansing Conditioner in the Cucumber Aloe. So that's cool, I haven't tried it yet. I've tried Wen a long time ago when my hair was still red, but I'll still try it anyway. And then another brand, which is Hello Hair, gave out hydrating mask samples. It's like a good like one use sample. Then someone was handing out these flash tattoos, and these are Minnie Mouse flash tattoos, and they're pretty cool. I thought they're awesome. There's like a little example on the, well, you guys can't really see it because it's white, but there's like cool things. My kids love Minnie Mouse. I was like, of course I'm gonna put some on for their amusement. And then it also had like other smaller ones. It had like symbols and stuff, little tiny dainty ones. There's like letters. Also came with Minnie Mouse. Look how cute this packaging is. Cuticle tattoos, so you put them on top of your nail color. On that note, this didn't come at BeautyCon, but I bought them to wear BeautyCon. I didn't. But if you're looking for flash tattoos and you don't want to get the ones that's four because they might be a little expensive because they're in the $20, $26 range, I think. It's around that. There's these. These are the Lulu DK for Target tattoos. I got it at Target and it was in the women's clothing section between like the swimsuits and stuff. Well, not swimsuits, but like the tops and the swimsuits in my area. And this was $15. And I love how like thick the tattoos are. I like really, really thick flash tattoos. I know this is kind of blinding you guys. Let me turn down. There you go. You can see them now. See, they're really, 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 really thick. And I like that. I haven't used them yet. I've tried really affordable flash tattoos and I feel like those wear off a lot faster. So I do usually like the flash tattoo brand one that Sephora sells, but to each their own. Some other Velvet 59 stuff. Check this out. Check this out. They have liquid lipsticks. And this shade is beautiful. I don't even know what the shade is. Cause that's the problem. I think I threw away the boxes. I don't have the shade names anymore. So that sucks. Oh, wow. What does it smell like? It smells like a typical like liquid lipstick. Almost smells like nothing. This is a beautiful, beautiful shade. And then there's like a brighter red. I was lucky enough to meet Paris, the owner, and she looked like a modern day Marilyn Monroe. It was her hair was beautiful there. I don't know if you guys saw her, but she is gorgeous. These are really nice and opaque and doesn't seem to be sinking into my fine lines. Then there's a nude lip gloss. This smells like shampoo. It's a nice, thick, opaque nude gloss right there. I wish I had names for you guys. I apologize, but I'll link their site down below and I'm sure it's not gonna be too hard to match to the shades. Then there's this really sparkly lip gloss. It was so different. It's like a peach with pearlescent purples inside of it. It's crazy. And then a couple more of her lipsticks. This one's more pinky than the other shade. Let me swatch them. Oh yeah, this is really pink. This is the shade and this was the earlier nude. My hand is gonna look crazy by the end of this video. This is a pinky pink for those who like pinks. Oh, it's like a lilac pink actually. Look how beautiful. Very lilac-y. These smell like lipstick. There's nothing crazy about it. They were also giving out this cleanser toner set, which was a sample. So I hope you guys don't mind how casual this video is. Like, I could be really, really formal and all that, but I want it to be just casual and kind of unstructured, just like going through what I brought back. So as I mentioned, NYX gave a lip color remover. In the bag, and I'm gonna try it out now because my hand is definitely stained. So here we go. Let's go put a little bit on since I don't want to get the applicator dirty. Whoa, it's thick. It's like Vaseline textured. Ooh. Ooh. I'm just gonna wipe it along the lip colors. Beauty guru problems. I always have like swatch stains on my left hand. It looks like I'm bruised after a while. But it's okay. Okay, and then I'm just gonna wipe it off. Oh! Wow. It works! It works pretty well too. It's not like a miracle worker, but if you rub in enough, like the spot that I put it in, it's pretty much all gone. I probably could use a little bit more right there, but that was nice. That was nice. And it smells like soft and like lip balm. To get into the brushes NYX gave us, so I gave away a very large majority of them, to be honest. I only kept a couple, and I'm pretty sure this looks like a lot for someone who's not crazy like me. I only kept a couple that I was interested in. At the same time, I might still give these away to someone in my family, but the few that I kept were these really soft studio looking ones. This one looked really nice for buffing, so I want to try that out. This was a unique shape. It's like a thick, fat fan brush. So I was thinking, I don't even know what I was thinking with this. I haven't really figured that out yet. We'll see what I end up using this for, but it's really, really dense. It's super soft. This looked like a flatter version and a wider version of the MAC 189 brush that I like for under my eyes, so I'm gonna give that a shot and see if it's like comparable to it. These don't have names, right? They have numbers. This is 08. This is 03. This is 06. And then this is 05, which is like almost like a 109, but smaller from MAC. It's like a dome shape brush. These look like the BH Cosmetic brushes that I use. This one is like cut in more of an angled way. This is 09. I love this type of brush for like eye primer or under eye concealer or just concealing under my brow in general. I love that. And these are good for like cream contouring in smaller areas. That's awesome. And this is a very soft pencil brush. This is number 15, a very nice and small one. So it's good for Asian eyes. And then flat liner brush, number 10. Blending brush, which I might not need, number 16. Angled brow brush, number 19. A shader brush, number 13. A lip brush, because you can never have too many of those, number 20. And then an angled spoolie dual-ended brow brush, which is number 18. These are the ones I kept, and the brush holder was very nice quality. Probably the nicest quality brush holder that I have. It's very thick, because the other ones I have are a little bit flimsier. I mean, this one's still clinging to it, because I've gotten the other ones like really messed up. But this is a really nice brush belt if you guys are looking for an affordable one. This is really, really, really nice. I'm sure all of the products I just showed you guys was available for purchase at Beautycon, or at least to play with and swatch, if anything. Let's see if my iron has heated up. I didn't turn it on yet. Oh, okay. So you hit the button and it flashes either low, medium, high, and I have it on medium now, so now it's gonna heat. It's pretty, pretty cool. The last thing I wanna show you guys is from Velvet 59 as well, and this is the Cream Contour Cream to Powder Makeup Palette, which is also vegan, cruelty-free, gluten-free, and paraben-free. This is interesting because there's not many cream to powder contour palettes. I'm gonna give you guys a closer look. Everything's matte, but this is the shimmery highlighter. They're very, very interesting. So, very, very creamy. You would think it'd be dried out because, oh wow, this is pretty good. It blends out very well. Like, I would use this because I don't like creams that stay too sticky. You know, I feel like those are harder to blend. And this, because I guess it's a cream to powder formulation, it doesn't do that. So I might have to do like a demo video with this palette if you guys are interested. Ooh, let's try the highlighters. This feels like a concealer almost. Oh wow, that's light. Definitely is a highlight. And then shimmery. Oh! I know you guys can barely see what I'm saying on my hand right now. Let me bring you a little closer. But so this is the concealer highlighter, and then the bronzer is right here. It blended out really, really naturally. These colors definitely wouldn't work as concealing just like to be natural, but if you're doing a dramatic contour and you're like my shade, this would work out. If you were lighter, you could probably use this more so for every day, but I think I fit more into like contouring with these two shades and then highlighting with this shade and possibly some of the yellow base shade, because that one's gonna be super light. It's hot now. Let's see. There's part of my bangs that I can't stand. Like, it always flops in the wrong direction. Let's curve some of my hair in, shall we? I mean, it feels good. It feels like it's working. It feels like it has enough heat on the medium setting, because I usually don't use very, very high settings. And it's not snagging or anything, so I am impressed. I just wonder how long the battery life lasts on this. I wish it was a little lighter, but of course, because the battery is internal, this whole section is pretty heavy. But it's something I would take traveling, because it is smaller. This might take a little bit more time if you have super long hair. And I'm sure you can curl your hair with this too. I just don't want to curl one strand right now. So I hope you guys enjoyed seeing everything as combined and crazy as this video was, is, and will continue to be until it's over. I apologize, but I will link off all the brands I featured down below if you're interested, and I will link off Beautycon's website. And I hope to follow up with a lot of videos. Let me know down below which video you're more interested in, so I can know what priority, you know, what order to film these for you all. I hope you guys have enjoying everything. Thank you as always for watching everything, and I hope to see you guys in future beauty events, and I hope you continue to watch. So I'll see you guys in a later video.